अब हमने 5 BHK ले लिया है, लंबी गाड़ी ले ली है,
वो सब तो ठीक है, पर बिटकॉइन लिया क्या?
कॉइन डीसी से डाउनलोड करो, 100 रुपए का फ्री बिटकॉइन एंजॉय करो।
सोचो मत, डाउनलोड करो। कुछ लकी विनर्स जीत सकते हैं पूरा एक बिटकॉइन।
चलिए जी, आज वर्ल्ड टेस्ट चैंपियनशिप फाइनल की स्पेशल कवरेज का आगाज करते हैं, और आज तो बड़ी खास शख्सियत हमारे साथ है। आप उनको स्क्रीन पर देख रहे हैं और उनके हाथ में क्या है वो भी आप देख रहे हैं। वी जॉइंड फ्रॉम इंग्लैंड बाय मिस्टर दिलीप जोडिया, और उनके हाथ में है ड्यूक्स का गेंद, वो बॉल जो वर्ल्ड टेस्ट चैंपियनशिप फाइनल में ये दो टीमें इस्तेमाल करेंगी, भारत और न्यूजीलैंड। इनफैक्ट आप लोगों को हैरानी होगी, ड्यूक्स का ये जो बॉल है ये 18th सेंचुरी से बनता आ रहा है, और दिलीप खुद इंडियन है, जब वहां पर गए तो उनको क्रिकेट का शौक भी था, और उसके साथ साथ उन्होंने कहा यार एक काम करता हूं मैं, ये जो ड्यूक्स बनाने की जो कंपनी है उसी को खरीद लेता हूं। वेलकम टू आवर व्यूअर्स इन इंडिया दिलीप जी। सब तो ये देखना चाहते हैं कि आपके हाथ में ये जो गेंद है क्या वही है जिसके हम बात कर रहे हैं बार बार वर्ल्ड टेस्ट चैंपियनशिप फाइनल के लिए?
यही है, दिस इज इट, वी आर जस्ट प्रिपेयरिंग देम नाउ टू सेंड, दीस आर एक्चुअली गोइंग टू साउथहैम्पटन फॉर द इंडियंस फॉर टुमारो
फॉर द प्रैक्टिस।
Yeah, they well, they get allocated X number of balls and they'll be there with them tomorrow.
और अगर आप दिखाएं कि इस पे ICC ने I think कुछ special logo भी लगवाया शायद।
Yes.
ये देखिए आप अपनी स्क्रीन पर World Test Championship Final का ये logo है। ICC
yes.
ने एक नई World Championship का आगाज किया, और must be proud moment for you के World Test Championship Final Dukes की गेंद से खेला जा रहा है।
Indeed, and it's the first World Test Championship, and also it's rather interesting that the two finalists don't normally use our ball.
Exactly, but ज़्यादा ये ball favour किसको करती है? Because मैं यहाँ पे मैंने ये Dukes का ball खोला हुआ है, Dukes Grade 1 special county ball जो England में इस्तेमाल होता है, West Indies में इस्तेमाल होता है, और दिलीप जी in India there is a saying कि जो हमारे यहाँ पे ये जो SG Test का ball इस्तेमाल होता है, कहते हैं ये और Dukes जो है वो भाई बहन है दोनों।
Well,
SG Test भी और Dukes भी हाथ से स्टिच होते हैं।
Yes, yes, indeed. But there's a huge difference in as much as it depends on the raw materials, it depends on the skill of the preparation, and it depends on what you do on the inside to keep the shape and the feel and so on. So that's the main difference. You know, people say, "What's the difference?" Well, the thing about cricket balls are they all look red and round or white and round, you know, and it's a cricket ball. But there's a huge amount of, you know, knowledge and technology that goes into the product. And what people should also understand is that it's a ball that gets hammered for 80 overs by a pretty solid piece of wood these days, you know, 3-pound bits of wood. And they have to keep their shape, and they have to, and in our view, they have to deteriorate gradually over 80 overs. So you the have the quick bowlers, and then as you go towards the middle of the innings, you know, the seamers get a chance, and then the spinners. And that's a balanced game of cricket. And this is what we bear in mind when we prepare the balls, you know, and this is historic. We know what to do. We've been doing it for years. And this is why the players kind of favor the ball, because it's the shape retention. You know, the problem is that you'll find every now and again the players will take the ball to the umpire and want it changed. And the regulations now say if it goes through a big ring, it's not out of shape. You could debate that, but that's what they judge the ball on. But people want to change the ball because they're not doing anything with it. So they think we'll get it changed. And very often, strangely enough, when they do change the ball, they might get a wicket straight away. So psychologically, this is a good thing. They want another ball. So we have to try and produce a ball that doesn't interrupt the game. And if you look at the history of cricket, you know, the Dukes balls are not many changes during the game. Having said that, I hope we don't have a spate of changes in this big game. You know, I might be pushing my luck when I say that. But in general terms, you know, we do everything we can to make sure that the ball is the very best. The big problem with cricket balls are I can't test this in any way before I hand it over to the players because it has to be brand new. So a failure of a product only appears in use. And that's one of the huge disadvantages of cricket balls.
But this,
so you
this
have
is
to
a
be
lot,
really, you have to know this.
Yeah,
sorry.
This is a lot which is being prepared for the World Test Championship final. But uske alawa, England and New Zealand are also playing a test series. I'm sure
yes.
Almost the same ball would also be used there.
It's the same ball. I mean, we carry out all the same procedures, same selection. It takes a long time, you know, for cricket balls, the cycle, you know, takes a long time from the basic cow through to the ball in your hand. It's a very long journey. So you can't suddenly produce cricket balls out of nowhere. The leather has to be prepared, and then you've got all the fabrication, then all the finishing. So yes, these balls have been on a journey for some time now. So what we do is obviously depending for test matches and so on, they're all the same balls, but we do hand selection. You know, I've been doing it for many years, and it's the way it feels in the hand. You know, we say, oh, it feels in the hand. Well, that's in your head. You know, that's something that you have by way of experience. And, you know, it'll say Anderson or some bowler will say, oh, you know, this feels good in the hand. That's what it's about.
But are there occasions when from season to season, the movement varies, the lot of the ball varies? Log kehte hain, yaar, is saal na ball swing nahi ho raha, yaar, is saal ball seam nahi ho raha. Do you also feel similar kind of problems?
Well, you see, again, people have to understand that the game of cricket, there are so many things. I mean, you've got the pitch for a start. And, you know, the conditions are not the same all around the world. That's the first thing. Then you've got weather condition. You know, it's not a fallacy. It's almost a known fact that in heavy conditions, humid, overcast, warm, you know, the ball swings more. And also there's a fallacy that a darker ball swings more than a lighter ball in color.
This one looks
not
very
every
dark.
Ball, yeah, not every ball is guaranteed to swing, you know, because the conditions are not the same. And this is why we at Duke's have a philosophy of producing balls with different surface finishes for different countries. So the ball that we produce in England, the ball in the West Indies is exactly the same ball, but has a totally different surface finish because of their conditions. And we've also had our ball in the Sheffield Shield in Australia, and also yet again another adjustment to the surface finish, and we've proved that we've got the right finish. So that's the way to do it, because you don't roll up a pitch and carry it around the world, do you, to play test cricket? They're all different surfaces.
Zyada ye ball Indian players will be excited, yeah, the New Zealanders, even though wo do test matches New Zealand bhi khelega, khel rahe hain already.
Yes.
Who would be more relieved, India or New Zealand? Ki chalo yaar, ye final jo hai, wo, well, I don't know
who's going to play for India in the final 11, but I mean the New Zealanders. I've always said actually that New Zealand have conditions just like England, and they happen to have a crop of bowlers who are swing bowlers. And Bolt, for example, I believe he's going to play in this Test match starting next week. Now, if I was running New Zealand cricket, I would play with the Duke's ball. That would give a huge home advantage to New Zealand. But they don't play with the Duke's ball because of commercial considerations, you see. So my view is that if you play with the right ball and you're successful, the commercial benefits will come. You know. So being given a commercial deal doesn't produce necessarily the success. They've been very successful, to be fair, for a small country, incredibly successful. I mean, I've been to New Zealand many times and seen, you know, the way they're organized, and, you know, they're small states, but they're very well organized, lots of coaching going on. And, you know, they're hungry for success. They want to be, they're not the number one sport. Rugby is the number one sport, but the cricketers want to be number one. So they try very hard. And there's no doubt when you see them, they're punching above their weight all the time. But I would use a Duke's ball in New Zealand because it's a natural, it will be just like England. You know, so when people come to England, oh, you know, it's the Duke's ball, they're all going to be slaughtered. Well, that's a lot of it's in the head. I mean, India did pretty well last time, even though they lost the series. I thought the bowlers bowled very well, and I think they all acknowledged that they enjoyed
it. It was the batting. It was the Indian batting that let the team down.
Yeah, but the batting is because they're not playing against a ball normally, which does a bit, you see. Because if you play in conditions where it's all to do with batsmen, then they get into bad habits. They're not naturally inclined to watch what the ball is doing. And if you remember the captain when he first came to England, not the last or the tour before, he was completely slaughtered, as you say, but he couldn't cope with it. But when he came back the following year, you know, the sort of guy that he is, he did his homework and he was a more successful batsman. Yeah? And he actually said in quotation that you can't go to England with an ego, because the Duke's ball will destroy you. Yeah. And it's not just the Duke's ball. It's a ball that behaves as it should do, which gives the bowler a little incentive, and it also gives the batsman a chance. So, you know, that's what we try and do to make sure there's this balance all the time, you know. So the balance comes from the knowledge of the construction. And then you have to leave it to the outside influences of, you know, the weather and the state of the pitch. I mean, the Chennai Test match, when England were there, I believe that the ball was destroyed. The seam was very roughed up, but the surface was grassless and so on. And that's what I go on about. And that is that if I knew that that was the situation, then I would make sure that I recommend to the people organizing the match that we treat the ball in such a way that the thread isn't destroyed by that pitch. You see, you can't say, oh, it's the pitch's fault. You should know what the pitch is going to do. And this is why we have this thing in the West Indies, to make sure that, you know, the balls behave and last in the West Indies. And I think that India need to, you know, the Indian board is the richest board in the world. And in my view, in my humble view, they should be, you know, looking for the best product for their cricket and not necessarily worrying about other issues. But, you know, I say this, I mean, I stick my neck out, probably not very popular in saying it, but I think common sense says that if you're the best team in the world or vying to be the number one team in this big final, then you need to make sure that you're carrying on trying to be up there and everything that you can have to assist you. I mean, let's face it, they have all these backroom staff of nutritionists, psychologists, and all that stuff. But at the end of the day, it's that ball. Without that, you can't have a game of cricket. You know, so it's very important that that ball is doing its job in an understated way. You don't want the ball being a topic of discussion, because that's bad news. You just want the ball to be doing its job.
Would you rather advocate a standard ball, puri duniya mein ek hi ball ka istemal ho?
No, well, it's very funny you should say that, because the MCC have a World Cricket Committee and they meet in various places, and they did meet in India a few years ago now. And as a result, because there was some problem with not my ball, but other balls, and, you know, they were not lasting and going out of shape and so on. And they had a discussion as to whether there should just be one ball for World Cricket. And I was called by journalists and, what do you think? And I believe that the gist of that conversation was that there should be one ball and it should be the Duke's ball. But I said to the journalists, I didn't agree with that. I said, no, there should not be just one ball for World Cricket, because there just isn't the same conditions everywhere. Like I discussed before, you don't roll up the pitch and carry it with you. You go to different countries, they're totally different. And this is why I believe that, you know, we should have different balls for different conditions. But, you know, Mike Gatting was ex-England captain, was the chairman of the committee, and I appeared before them. And he said, it's very strange that, you know, we recommended there should be one ball and it should be yours, but I believe you don't agree with that. So I said, well, I think, Mr. Chairman, you know, you have to be a little bit careful about the interpretation of what might be said in the media and how it's said, you know. I said, I didn't say that it shouldn't be my ball, you know, the brand, but I said it shouldn't be the same ball without any changes all over the world. That wouldn't be right. That would be wrong. And so, you know, they had a laugh and it was quite good fun.
Yeah.
But so I believe that, you know, we are a bespoke, you know, I'm just plugging ourselves. We are all cricket maniacs here working together. And we truly believe that, you know, at the very top level, the ball should be hand-stitched, not machine-stitched. And then care should be given to the conditions and to have people who can respond to that and produce the very best product so that it's a seamless experience in playing a game of cricket. And that's what we aim to do. And I'm pleased to say, quite successful at it where we get an opportunity. But there are places where we can't get an opportunity because of commercial considerations. So, you know, what can we do? Can't do a lot.
Jamap, when you prepare a ball, let's say this season, this English season, so aap jab ball prepare karte hain, and already you are in the midst of preparation for the World Test Championship as well. Lots mein fark pad jata hai ki jaise ye do test matches hue England aur New Zealand ke. So would the ball be any different in any way from the one which will be used in Southampton? No.
No.
It'll be exactly the same.
Yeah. Process is exactly the same. And then there'll be this big game. And then there'll be the series against India coming up, five games. All these balls are already in process. You know, there's no change. There's no, you know, it's absolutely the same. The only thing that happens in the sense that I go through all the various balls and I do the final selection. You know, it's this question of feel and so on. So there's no difference in the way it's made or whatever. It's a sort of a psychological thing. And because I've been doing it for so long, I'd like to think that I can think like the bowlers. You know, what do these guys look for? You know?
So how do you test? How do you test? Do you go and bowl in your
It's the feel in the hand. You know, I mean, I'm holding a ball now. And it's a funny thing, actually, because, there are size and weight and all the regulations. But when you feel balls, they do feel different, some of them. And there is, you know, a tolerance between the minimum size and the maximum size. And we try our very best to make everything to the middle of the tolerances, because I think that's the fairest way to go. Once you've got a tolerance to be heavier or bigger, I don't think that's good for cricket. So at this level, those balls we weed out, if anything doesn't come up to our specification within what we've done, we put them aside and sell them off for net practice or whatever. So the very best balls, we accumulate them throughout a production process all the time, and then we go through them again and again and again. We come up with the very best selection. And that's the way to do it. And, you know, it gives us great pride to say, you know, it works. And I get a little nervous before the first ball is bowled, you know, to make sure everything is in order. And once the first ball is gone, then you know, yes, the game
match, drops. Match balls are manufactured kar chuke hain, or it'll be up to the ICC to decide whichever that they want to pick?
What, the actual balls?
Yeah, match balls.
For the game.
Yeah.
Yeah, no. I pick the balls and send them. I pick the balls for all the test matches.
Manufactured already?
Yeah, they're manufactured. I'm holding a ball now. You know, I've got the finals.
Sir, if you
finals,
could show this to the viewers.
Yeah.
If
where's my camera? Oh, there we are.
Yes. Lijiye, aap dekh lijiye. ICC ne wo stamp bhi lagayi hai. Duke's ka ye ball hai. Grade 1, which will be used for the World Test Championship Final, India or New Zealand. And this game, filhal jo Dilip ji ke haath mein hai, wo hai jo India ko practice ke liye bheji ja rahi hai, but jo match balls hain, wo bhi already wo tag kar chuke hain. Thoda sa dark color lag raha hai.
It's very dark. Chain. Well, yes, there's grease. You see, the I can just show you that these are the balls for the test match being prepared, and we have what we call mills. I don't know. Can you see this? This is where we shape the balls. Can you see that?
Yes, I can.
Yeah. So they have to sit in here for a period of time. They're sitting there now, you know, so they give them so much time, then we turn them around and so on. And that's why you get this shape. And the shape is something, you know, you can't really describe in words. It's something that people know. It's something they have in their genes, you know, they realize. So the balls are dark because, you know, the difference again between the Kookaburra ball and ours is that there's grease in our balls. You know, the waterproofing is done by grease is applied. And the same thing happens with the SG ball in India. Whereas the Kookaburra ball, because of their harsh and hard conditions, have a different type of surface finish. And our balls for the West Indies also don't have this grease.
Oh.
Strangely enough, I'm actually processing some balls for the West Indies. They're just due to go to the West Indies. Here we are. You can see, I hope you can see the color. Coincidentally, they're due to leave for their test series against Pakistan.
But thoda sa, it's slightly a cherry color, and this one is darker. The one being used in England is darker. And I think the difference also is in the shine. That is shiny, and this one has matte finish. Just like
No. This will be shiny when we put a top coat, but it doesn't last long. It just disappears.
Yeah.
But this will last. This shiny finish will last.
That's precisely the reason why SG Test or Dukes, the moment it starts getting older, it doesn't lose its seam. It doesn't lose the hardness, or easily a reverse swing also comes into play.
Yes.
Whereas the Kookaburra gets softer. I said Dukes, yes, you see, and to an extent SG, jaise purana hota jayega, it doesn't lose its hardness, doesn't lose its seam as well.
Yes. You see, the problem with the machine stitch ball is that when you look at the stitching, you see six rows of stitching. Okay.
Six. Yes.
The yeah. So exactly with a hand stitch ball, all stitching is going from one side to the other through the ball. So the whole ball is being held together by six rows of stitching. With a kookaburra ball, only the middle two rows are holding the ball. The outer two Baki rows of stitching are just machine stitched. It's dummy stitched.
And that's just for the grip. That's just for the grip.
Yeah. And also, you know, that's a tradition. You know, that's what a cricket ball should look like. So, I mean, we can make machine stitched balls. We don't choose to do so because in our view, that is just an improvisation to, you know, take advantage of, you know, fast production or the lack of skilled workers or whatever it is. So, you know, if you didn't have them, you'd have to find a solution. And machine stitching is one of those. But I don't think really it should be allowed in international cricket, in my view. And I mean, if you look at the white ball, if you look at the white ball scenario, look at the scores.
Exactly.
You know what's happening?
The ball doesn't do much. मुझे याद है जब white ball start हुआ था 80s में तो लोग कहते थे यार white ball ज़्यादा swing करता है. But
yeah,
it's changed entirely now.
Yes, and it doesn't swing because it doesn't have the seam that acts as a radar. You know, as a conduit. It's a, you know, like a fin. It makes the thing move because there is resistance of air against the seam. If you have a machine stitch seam, after a while it flattens down, and then there's nothing for the aerodynamics to take place. That's the reason.
Dilip ji, have you looked at the weather forecast in Southampton? I think thoda sa bata rahe hain ki it could be cloudy, might rain a couple of days as well. I'm not very sure about the pitch that is being prepared. So aap us test match ko kaise dekhte hain? Will it be a high scoring game ya phir bowlers?
Well, I think that the pitch will be fine because they're all under cover all the time. So there's no chance of any wet, doesn't matter. That's all taken care of. So the pitch will be dry. It'll be a good pitch. I suspect there will be movement because if it's quite warm now, suddenly we've got 25 degrees here. And this morning it was quite humid. So if this carries on, I suspect the swing bowlers, I think Bolt will probably be very effective. No doubt about that. Southee also is quite effective. And then Bumrah, of course, if he's playing. And I don't know who else will play. Ishant might play.
Ishant, most likely.
Well, they swing the ball as well. So I think the swing bowlers will do well. I think it's a question of whether they pitch the ball up or not. I think if they want swing, they've got to pitch it up. I think, you know, bang it halfway down the pitch and expect it to move is a waste of time. So I think, but whatever ball, you know. So I think that that'll be the case. I think it's just a question of a game plan and sticking to it. That should be the case because, you know, both sides have got quite good batting. So I think, you know, they hopefully be good scoring game with a bit of luck. But let's hope it doesn't get interfered with by weather because that, like this last test match, you know, just, I mean, it's a good declaration by New Zealand and it just fizzled out. You know, it should have been a bit more exciting.
So if you know, people, you were to pick a winner, your prediction, Dilip ji?
No, I have to be entirely neutral.
You can't.
In my profession, I should not make any comment as to who I favor.
You'll have to probably separate your passion from your profession for a while.
No, I'm a friend of everybody. You know, in the cricket market, it's I do really seriously enjoy cricket when I watch it, and I love to see people doing well. And of course, I've got lots of friends. You know, I've traveled a lot over the years, you know, particularly with India, going back in history, my generation of, you know, Sunil Gavaskar and people like that. You know, one was close to those players. But even then, you know, when they're playing against Australia, it's the challenge is to see, you know, who's doing well, and, you know, one feels good for them. But you know, I think at the end of the day, whether you like it or not, it depends on where you were born. And that's a sort of a genes thing, isn't it? I mean, you subconsciously, that's what you want success to be, you know. And I think anybody denies that. I mean, I've got a friend of mine, English guy who I knew years ago, who lives in Australia. And he still backs England in the Ashes, you know, when they go and play there. Even though he's married to an Australian, he's lived there for 45, 50 years. And so it's in the genes. So that's the way it is. But I do try and be neutral because at the end of the day, I do deal with all these people. And I think it's sort of politics. You have to be seen to be neutral, and that's what we try and do. We don't try and favor anybody, obviously, in terms of, I mean, over the years, you might be interested to know that we've had people trying to say, well, what can we do this and that to the ball? No, the ball, the standard is absolutely set in stone. There is no deviation, nothing to interfere with the way we do things, you know, in a professional way. And that is why we have the reputation that we have. People want to say, oh, can you put a little more polish on this side? Going back in history, one of the counties years ago said, can we have ball stamped just one side with gold? I said, why is that? Because we think it'll swing more. And he said, sorry, that's not possible. We can't.
One last question, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, we know that England mein the conditions, and this is the first half of the summer, even though garmi aa gayi hai, but pitches mein shayad you won't have drier surfaces. With this ball, the ball that you showed us for the World Test Championship final, will it also help the spinners?
Yes, of course it will, because you know that's what I'm saying. A good cricket ball, which has a good seam, which keeps its hardness, keeps its shape, will provide bounce. You know, I mean, that's the other thing about spin. It's not just the
especially
fact that
if it
might
pitches
turn
on the seam.
Yeah, it has to bounce. So, yeah, overall, we just keep in mind all aspects of the game. And when people say, oh, well, you know, they can't spin a Duke's ball. I mean, you know, that's nonsense. I mean, Ravi Ashwin is on television saying that he prefers to bowl with it. So, you know, one can only go on what the players say, and the top players all say it. I mean, even the great Shane Warne, you know, I mean, he's a great advocate for Duke's balls, and he thinks it should be used in Australia all the time in all first-class cricket. So, you know, I can only go on what other people say. I mean, naturally, I'd say it, but naturally, I'm biased, but other people saying it is encouraging.
Thank you very much, sir.
Great pleasure.
For letting us peep into the preparations, because jo ball Dilip ji ke haath mein ek bar phir agar wo dikha dein, to ye wo gende hai ji jo World Test Championship final ke liye taiyar ki ja rahi hai. ICC ka ek special logo bhi is par laga hai. Aur I hope ki test match bhi usi tarah ka ho. Jo kehte hai, it befits the title game. Thank you very much, Mr. Dilip Jajodia.
Thank you for having me on. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Sports से जुड़ी किसी भी अपडेट के लिए Sports तक को सब्सक्राइब करें और हमारे Facebook और Instagram पेज को भी जरूर फॉलो करें.